Welcome to Bio-Rad's Blackboard Training. This is a series of short, informal tutorials brought to you by industry experts. Today, we'll cover Total Allowable Error, or TEA. TEA is the analytical quality specification that sets limits for imprecision and bias that are allowable in a single test result. There are several models that can be used to establish total allowable error limits. A few of them are published professional recommendations, regulatory bodies and agencies, calculations using biological variation data, and laboratory established performance goals. This tutorial is going to focus on the last model, using biological variation data to calculate a total allowable error limit. The TEA formula consists of three components: Z-score, imprecision goal percent, or CVA, and the bias goal percent, or BA. The Z-score is the desired probability of inclusion inside the targeted limits. Dr. Cullum Fraser provided the following examples of probabilities and Z-scores in his text, Biological Variation from Principles to Practice. If we desire to include 99% of the values within our target limits, then we should use a Z-score of 2.33. This equals an inclusion probability of P less than 0.01. To calculate for the imprecision goal percent, there are two key pieces of information that are required: published biological variation data within subject, and the performance goal for imprecision that the laboratory wants to achieve. First, how do we determine if there's published biological variation data for a test? A database of values can be found at www.qcnet.com within the documents section. This is what the database looks like. Once it's been determined that there's published biological variation data for the test, the performance goal for imprecision needs to be chosen by the laboratory. The approach that's going to be discussed here is based on the work of Dr. Cullum Fraser, a leading expert in the field of biological variation and its application in the clinical diagnostic laboratory. The choice of a performance goal is linked to specific formulas for calculating allowable error. The outputs of these formulas are specific performance targets traceable to the chosen performance goal. They are represented as a numerical value expressed as a percent that defines the limit for imprecision and bias. There are three performance goals from which the laboratory can choose: minimum, desirable, or optimal. A minimum performance goal is intended to be used for those tests for which technology is not yet available to achieve a desired performance. It's also intended for those laboratories that, for whatever reason, say lack of resources, etc., are not able to achieve a desired performance. A desirable performance goal is defined as the most widely accepted and frequently used quality specification. The optimum performance goal is intended for those tests for which desirable performance is easily obtained. This is a stretch goal. Using the formula suggested by Dr. Fraser, allowable imprecision is calculated where CVA represents total allowable imprecision and CVW represents within subject biological variation as published. If we were to choose a performance goal for imprecision of desirable and the published CVW is 5.7%, then the CVA would be 2.85%. The last component that we need for our equation is our bias goal percent. To calculate the bias goal percent, there are two pieces of information that are needed: published biological variation data, both within subject and between subjects, and the performance goals for bias that the laboratory wants to achieve. We already know where we can go to retrieve biological variation data, so we'll move on to choosing a performance goal for bias. We have the same three performance goals to choose from for our bias goal: minimum, desirable, or optimum. Using formulas suggested by Dr. Fraser, allowable bias is calculated as shown where BA represents total allowable bias, CVW represents within subject biological variation, and CVB represents between subject variation. If we were to choose a performance goal for bias of desirable, and the published CVW is 5.7% and the CVB is 6.9%, then the BA would be 2.24%. Now that we understand all the components, let's practice calculating a TEA for serum glucose. Let's move our formula down into the corner just in case we need it. These are our values for our imprecision goal percent, CVA, and our bias goal percent, BA. We've chosen a z-score of 1.65 because we want to include 95% of the values within our target limits. Let's begin by copying down our formula and then substituting in the values. We multiply the z-score by the CVA and then add the BA. The TEA turns out to be 6.94%. Now let's do a practice equation of your own. Pause the video when the values appear. This will give you a chance to grab pen, paper, or calculator. Calculate the TEA, then restart the video. I'll provide the correct answer and how I got it. Here are our values. Remember that our formula is in the corner. Go ahead and pause the video now. The TEA is 1.49%. Here's how I got that figure. First, I substituted the values into the formula. Next, I multiplied and then added. How do we use TEA? Remember, TEA is a quality specification or budget for allowable error within a test result. By comparing a test's total error to the total allowable error, we can determine if the test is within budget. I encourage you to take a look at our video for calculating TE if you need additional information. To ensure that we're in budget, the TE cannot exceed the TEA. If we determine that the TE for a test is 10.1% and the TEA is 6.94%, the TE exceeds the TEA, so the laboratory is failing to meet the quality specifications for the test and corrective action needs to be taken. We hope you found this tutorial helpful. For all of your QC needs, visit www.qcnet.com.